Good day, viewers. You are on to Mathematics with Dr. Oji. In this video, we shall solve some tutorial questions on acute angles. Subscribe to my video channel by clicking the subscribe button below the video and the notification bell so that each time I upload a new video, you will be notified. Thank you. Now the question goes, if sine theta is equal to 1 all over root 3, and 0 degree less than equals to theta less than equals to 90 degree. Find the values of other trigonometric ratios of the angle theta. Now, we don't need to waste our time. What we just need to do is to recall all the formula we've learned before. Now, we have been given that the theta is an acute angle, as you can see from the definition. Okay, so we now recall. Suppose we want to find the value of sine theta. Recall, know that sine squared theta, recall, plus cos squared theta is equals to 1. We know that? Okay? Now, we've known sine theta. That means we need to find the value of cos theta. So here, cos squared theta will be equals to 1 minus sine squared theta. From that, if we make cos squared theta, we solve the formula. When sine theta goes to the other side, come minus. Okay? So, cos theta will just be find the square root of both sides. 1 minus sine square theta. Because cos square theta is a square value. And so, the square root of this, the square root of this will give you that. Okay? So, which will be equal to what? The square root of 1 minus. And if your sine theta is 1 over 3, then sine squared theta will be 1 over root 3 squared. So this will be what? The square root of 1 minus 1 over root 3 squared will be what? 1 over 3. Okay? Yes. So the SM, that's cos theta, is equals to the SM of 1 minus 1 over 3. That will be SM is 3, 1 and 3, 3 minus 1, that's 2 all over 3. Okay, so our cos theta is the 2 over 3. Now, having known this, what will be the value of our tan theta? Because we have to find the values of the other trigonometric ratios. Okay, we recall that since tan theta is equal to sine theta over cos theta, that implies, and sine theta is 1 all over root 3 all over cos theta we have gotten now is root 2 over 3. Okay, so what follows? That will not what? Tan theta is equal to 1 over root 3 divided by root 2 over root 3. That is the meaning of this. So we've got 1 over root 3 times root 3 all over root 2. So this will cancel this. So you have what? 1 over root 2. So that is our tan theta. Now, we've known tan theta, we need to find cosec theta, we need to find sec theta, we need to find cos theta. Now, what is what? Cosec theta is what? Recall, cosec theta is equal to 1 over sine theta. Okay? So we recall that. Which is what? 1 over root 3. And that's what? Root 3. Okay? Yes. Okay. Now, sec theta will be what? 1 over cosine theta. Will be what? 1 over. Our cos theta from this calculation is root 3 over root 2 over root 3. Okay? Root 2 all over root 3. So, now be what? 1 over 1 divided by, which is will be times root 3 all over what? All over root 2. That's root 3 over root 2. So we have gotten sec theta to be root 3 over root 2. Now, what is cot theta? Cot theta will be 1 over tan theta. So and that will be what? 1 all over. What is our tan theta? The tan theta we obtain is 1 over root 2. Okay? So that will be 1 over 1
times root 2 over 1, which is going to what? Root 2.
So, that is that for that. Now we move to the next question. We move to the next question. The next question says, that's example 2. Example 2. Show that 1 plus cos theta all over 1 minus cos theta sec theta minus 1 all over sec theta plus 1 is equals to 1. Okay? Is equals to 1. Now, how do we show this? It's very simple. We just need to recall our formula. Okay, that is, if you multiply this by this, you must have 1. Now, let's look at the possible combination between sec theta and cos theta. Well, we know that sec theta, sec theta is equals to 1 over cos theta. Do we still remember that? Yeah. Okay. That is it. Sec theta is equal to 1 over cos theta. And eventually, we also know that we can do substitution here. So as to make it, fast enough. And be able to eliminate some values. Let's do some substitution here. And see what we're going to arrive at. So, if sec theta equals to 1 over cos theta, now, that means that we could replace sec theta here by 1 over cos theta. So, that will now be, can I have 1 plus, cos theta all over 1 minus cos theta, multiplied by sec theta, which is 1 over cos theta minus 1, then all over sec theta, which is what? Sec theta, that's 1 over cos theta, 1 over cos theta plus 1. We want to show that the left-hand side is equal to the right-hand side. So let's deal with this first. So that we don't get ourselves into trouble. So 1 over cos theta minus 1 over 1, what would that be? LCM is cos theta. Cos theta and cos theta, 1 times 1, 1 minus 1 in cos theta. So we have gotten the value for the numerator there. And so also 1 over cos theta plus 1 over 1 will be what? SM is cos theta. So that's cos theta and cos theta, 1 times 1, 1 plus 1 in cos theta times 1, that's cos theta. So now we have gotten that. So we can replace, let's replace that. So that means for this side we now have what? 1 minus cos theta all over cos theta. Then all over here means multiplying it as reverse, cos theta all over 1 plus cos theta. So this will cancel this. So we'll be left with what? 1 minus cos theta all over 1 plus cos theta. So the result of this is now what? Which implies 1 plus cos theta all over 1 minus cos theta multiplied by 1 minus cos theta all over 1 plus cos theta. So clearly, this will cancel this. This is 1. This will cancel this. It's 1. So the result is 1. So we've been able to prove that that is equal to 1. So please don't forget, subscribe to my video channel by clicking the subscribe button below the video. Thanks and God bless you.